Welcome to tonight's commencement ceremony for the class of 2020. Please stand while the Class of 2020 choir sings our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
We began this year with so many hopes and dreams for the Class of 2020. We asked students and staff to share their stories and understand how our stories impact our ability to learn and grow. Considering all of the challenges and unexpected changes of this year, this was never more important. As you know, our core values of civility, awareness, respect, and embracing each other have been taught and reinforced throughout your journey in Fairport Schools. However, living these values during a global pandemic, this has been truly a test of character, grit, and perseverance. While we haven't made it to the other side, and we're still very much living with the unknown, it hasn't stopped our students from demonstrating grace, charity, and empathy for each other and our community. So much of high school is based on various rites of passage, and this class is faced with the prospect of losing some of these opportunities. But years from now, the unique memories will still be there. It may not be of your ball dress or the last day at Darien Lake, but you will have countless memories of your efforts to stay connected with your friends, families, and teachers through Hangouts and Zoom sessions, amusing yourself with TikTok videos, binging on Netflix, Hulu, and the like, finding unique ways to care for your grandparents and neighbors in the most trying of times has only strengthened your resolve to make an impact on this world. And make an impact you will. We are confident in that belief, that you have a strong base to build on and will take your talent and drive to college, the workplace, and the military, and dedicate yourself to a dream. It's clear we need your enthusiasm, your ideas, and your energy. You've grown up in a different world than most of us and have a unique lens to help lead us into a different era, one absent of inequality, racism, sexism, and hatred. Your leadership is vital to forging a path of opportunity that is inclusive of all people and ideas, and you are equipped to guide us through the change we need to see. And now for a few words of wisdom for our graduates to guide you on your next journey. First, take care of the people that take care of you. It's a simple concept, but one we may take for granted. This approach to life breeds loyalty and love between friends and families and pays dividends beyond your comprehension in times of need. And second, you alone decide what type of person you will be. Make a conscious choice to be a good friend, a good student, a good worker, and perhaps someday a good parent. It is the only thing you have control over. Your character is the sum total of the quality of your effort in work, in relationships, and in life. Lastly, a special request. Come home when you can. I'm sure for some of you, the idea of fleeing Fairport might be the most appealing idea you've ever heard. And for others, it might be the scariest. When you leave, you will gain a perspective that every adult that works and lives in our community has. This is an amazing place to live and raise a family. This realization may take some time, and that's okay. So long as you remember that you are a product of Fairport, and wherever you go and whatever you do, you are part of our family. Thank you for making us all proud to be Raiders. As I think about the path in front of each of you, I'm confident that you're well prepared. There will most certainly be adversity in your future. Remember that you're not alone. Although we are many Raiders, we are one family. You have each other and all of your collective experiences to draw confidence from as you find your way. And of course, you have your Fairport community, and we truly believe that saying, once a Raider, always a Raider. We look forward to hearing about all of your future success. Congratulations to the class of 2020. At this time, I'd like to introduce our honored guest this evening. It is my pleasure to introduce our valedictorian, Mr. David Munichika, salutatorian, Emily Pollock, class president, Jane Kellerman, vice president, Morgan Schwab, secretary, Josie Keenan, treasurer, Emily Pollock, our guest speaker, Mr. Michael Alessandro, class advisors, Mr. DeMay, Mr. Miller, and Mr. Goosey, and Mrs. Russell. I'd also like to introduce our district office leadership, our superintendent of schools, Mr. Brett Provenzano, our assistant superintendent, Mrs. Cass Wheeler, and our assistant superintendent for business, Mr. Matt Stevens, as well as our assistant superintendent for human resources, Mr. Doug Bob. I'd also like to introduce our Board of Education, led by our president, Mr. Peter Forsgren, vice president, Mr. Damon Buffum, Mrs. Marty Cardona, Mr. Kevin Glover, Ms. Joyce Kostick, Ms. Judy O'Leary Sargent, and Mr. Tim Sliz. I'd also like to acknowledge the rest of the building administrators, Mrs. Lindsay Kyle, Mr. Dominic Monticelli, Mr. Kevin Page, and Mrs. Leanna Watt. Our guidance counselors have worked tirelessly over the last 3 years to ensure this day would be a reality for all of our students. Mrs. Marty Buttendeck, Mrs. Christina Cardamone, Mrs. Francine Newtown, Mrs. Teresa Howe, Mr. Craig Howe, and Mrs. Heather Manila. And lastly, we'd like to welcome any other faculty and staff member that's participating in the evening. At this time, I'd like to introduce our choir, which will be singing You Will Be Found from Dear Evan Hansen under the direction of Dr. Jim Jeffers.
Ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? Like you could fall and no one would hear?
So let that lonely feeling wash away, 'cause maybe there's a reason to believe you'll be okay. 'Cause when you don't feel strong enough to stand, you can reach out your hand.
And oh, someone will come running. And I know
they'll take you home.
Even when the dark comes crashing through, when you need a friend to carry you, and when you're broken on the ground, you will be found. So let the sun come streaming in, 'cause you'll reach up and you'll rise again.
The good thing about the past is we can always come back to it in our memories. We shouldn't forget where we came from, but we shouldn't live in the past either. Whether the future waits with open arms or not is up to us. Thanks to all who made our journey thus far what it was, because we couldn't have done it alone.
There's a place where you don't have to feel alone. And every time
join me in welcoming Mr. Peter Forsgren, President of the Board of Education, to offer a warm welcome to the graduates.
13 years ago, just a few months before you entered your kindergarten year, the Board of Education asked the citizens of this community if they would help pay for your education. And they said yes. So we sent them out a tax bill. And by the time your kindergarten year was over, we had spent about $102 million. Then we did it again, just a few months before you entered into first grade. We asked the community, will you help pay to educate the children of this community? And they said yes. And once again, we sent them out a tax bill. And by the time that year was over, we had spent about $104 million. This process has repeated itself over and over again until you now are here at your senior year. Should anyone ask if the community values you, you can say yes, and you can put a dollar figure around that. We have spent over those 13 years about $1.5 billion. Some might ask, what could we have done with that $1.5 billion? But I am confident that this community would resoundingly say the same thing they have said here and year again and again. We will educate our children. We believe in them. We want to give them a foundation that they can take and build upon to have a better life, that they can help create a better world for them, for their community, for their friends. We did not know 13 years ago that the year of your graduation would be different than all the other classes before you. We did not know that 13 years ago. We did not know that 6 months ago. But this last year is now part of your education. You have that foundation. That experience is now part of you. Change, disappointment, celebrations in unique ways, adaption, problem solving, all of this is part of your education. So we encourage you, take the investment this community has made in you. Take all the knowledge you have gained. Take all the love that has been given and build upon it. Make the next years of your life better. We believe in you. We love you. We support you. We celebrate you. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Thank you, Mr. Forsgren, and thank you for your leadership. It is my pleasure to invite our superintendent, Mr. Brett Provenzano, to the podium to offer his remarks to the class of 2020. Mr. Provenzano.
Greetings. Just because we're experiencing graduation differently this year does not take away the special meaning and symbolism of this very important moment. In fact, as we celebrate the class of 2020, we are doing it with a deeper sense of appreciation. Thank you to Mr. Clark and to your team for seeking feedback from school members and planning graduation festivities differently this year. All look different than in past years. We are thrilled to be sharing these moments with family, friends, and of course, our graduates of 2020. Some thank yous are certainly in order. Parents, guardians, and family members, thank you for sharing your children with us. It has been a true privilege to be a part of your children's journeys. We share in your joy, pride, and love of your children. To our esteemed Board of Education, thank you for keeping our students at the forefront while being strong advocates for their education. Through various platforms, the Board's vision and mission has given a voice to our students. Every year is vital. And the most important one in a child's educational experience is a frequent mantra that I hear while interacting with this Board of Education. There's too many to mention for this very moment, but just follow a Thoroughbred Instagram or Twitter feed, and one can see the depths of our district's programming that mirror the Board's high expectation for our students and our schools. To our Fairport educators, and as I frequently say, anyone who works with and is invested in our children on behalf of our schools is an educator. We thank you. You have taken advantage of our intentional programming to connect with our students and influence their lives at all levels, and was even more so pronounced during this closure. You meet students where they are.
You show up for students before, during, and after school. You show up for them online. Celebrations, parades. You have been at their youth ball games, recitals, and in other life-defining moments. You do the little things that mean so much to our impressionable students who seek your tutelage, advocacy, and unconditional love. You do this so they can discover and be the best version of themselves. Class of 2020, it has been a privilege seeing you journey through our schools. Through the years, you have learned and gained scholarship and success in extracurricular activities, the arts, sciences, humanities, and athletics. However, it seems at times we have learned more from you than you have learned from us. Since you started school 13 years ago, there have been great advancements in our world. Advancements which you intuitively gravitate toward, and ones that will shape your career path and social experiences moving forward. 3D printing, augmented reality, biotechnology, the next iteration of the cloud, streaming, podcasts, touchscreen technology, and of course, iPhones, Androids, and of course, social media platforms, which include Twitter, Instagram, and definitely TikTok. These are incredible advancements in technology, but please let me share one last final thought with the class of 2020. Your character counts, and how we treat each other means more than the glory of our accomplishments as a society. Advancements in technology, the arts, and the great feats of humanity mean little if we do not take care of each other. As you have learned in your time in Fairport, we are always better together. We are always better when we reach out to each other, lean on each other, and find ways to lift each other up in any and all circumstances. We measure our success as a school district by what you give back to the world once you leave our schools. We hope and have faith that you will give the talents you have cultivated right here in our Fairport schools right back to the world. Wherever your future brings you, it will be up to you to solve the greater issues and unanswered questions of the day. You will discover that you are most satisfied in yourselves when you strive to make a difference in the world. You will discover that Fairport is a very special place because of how we embrace the ideals of brotherhood and sisterhood. Nobody does it the way we do it here in this community. It's at the core of who we are and distinguishes our caring community, and it is the one trait that I am most proud of, and you will be proud of it too. I hear it all the time. Be convicted to transfer the enduring concepts of civility, awareness, respect, and embracing differences to your next destination. Continuing to bring these ideals are fundamental, and they will bring joy to your individual circumstances and much needed joy to the world. They still count and will count even more once you leave our schools. Finally, please know that you have been our greatest source of pride. Be proud to be a Fairport graduate. Be proud of the values that link us together as one family. Be proud that no matter how big or how small it may have seemed, you have added to the legendary and dynamic Fairport tapestry with class, style, and pride. We love you, thank you, and congratulations.
Our next speaker is off to Cornell University this fall to major in biology. Please join me in welcoming our salutatorian, Ms. Emily Pollack.
Class of 2020, congratulations, we made it from the dining room table. It has been quite a ride to get here, but we all did it, and for that, you should be very proud. To the parents of the graduates, congratulations, we made it through 15 weeks of turning your house into Fairport High School. None of us graduating today could have done so without your guidance, love, and support. So thank you for everything that you do for all of us. To the teachers, administrators, and staff at Fairport High School, congratulations, we made it, despite all the awkward Google Meet silences. You rose to the occasion, finding new ways to continue teaching us at home and keep the Fairport community alive. Thank you to each and every one of you who make Fairport such a special place to go to school. Now, let me take you on a walk through Fairport High School, through my eyes as an FHS senior. You get out of your car in the back parking lot and lock the doors with a satisfying beep. Your class of 2020 lanyard in hand, keys jangling, just to make sure that everyone can tell you're a senior. When you get inside, Dennis greets you with a warm, "Hey, how are you?" and you wave to the other sentries. You look to your left down the hallway, a long stretch of musical opportunity. In the choir room, you spent hundreds of days singing beautiful music with your friends. In the band room, you lost track of time gazing at the paintings on the walls and somehow ceilings, wondering about the past Fairport students who created them. You continue walking past the auditorium, where you took a bow in front of a sold-out house after a performance of West Side Story, and where a crowd of screaming students cheered you on like you were a pop star while singing at the holiday jazz concert. To your right is the FHS gym, where you and the other seniors, decked out in red from head to toe, screamed "Go Bananas" at the top of your lungs to win the coveted Raider Cup. Next, you pass the cafeteria, where you furiously scribbled notes at one of Mrs. Edwards' epic global history review sessions, and feverishly debated how to solve a math problem at a meet with the Fairport math team. And where the seniors piled in one winter day when senior privileges were canceled, everyone Googling the definition of snow squall to see if that was even a real thing. You continue walking and pass room 109 as Mr. Gillette sings a perfect hatball shot from the doorway. You see Mrs. Gitlin and her students doing tree pose in the hallway for some pre-class yoga. And the math classroom, where you stayed after class countless times to ask and scream in questions, and she went above and beyond to help you. These memories and experiences are what all of the seniors will take away from Fairport. The small moments and unique aspects that make Fairport more than just a school, but a community and a family. And we, the class of 2020, will cherish these memories even more than most classes, because when we scurried to our cars at 2:10 p.m. on March 13th, we had no idea that we would never have another day at FHS again. So we'll hold close the memories of battling it out in a debate in Mr. Malibur's AP US History class, of square dancing to Mr. Callahan's classic rendition of Pink Cadillac, cheering at a Friday night football game where there is so much spirit in the atmosphere that it feels straight out of a movie, watching Mr. Martin show off his amazing math-inspired dance moves the day of prom, eating donuts in the parking lot of the rec center on the first day of school, and Mr. Page busting down on the dance floor at the Boston Dance. But now, to add to all of this, we'll also have the memories of decorating our cars and waving to our teachers at the senior parade, watching Gmail's fire rap videos on the morning message, and feeling like a celebrity with a home of a Fairport senior sign proudly displayed in our lawn. What an unforgettable senior year this has been. As glasses are raised tonight to the class of 2020, one might dwell on the notion of whether the glass is half empty or half full, whether the experience of being a high school senior during the COVID-19 pandemic should be viewed in an optimistic or pessimistic manner. However, I don't think this is the important question. What really matters is what we can do to fill up our glass and make the best out of a situation. And that is what we as seniors have done during this global pandemic. Even though we couldn't be inside the walls of Fairport High School to finish out our senior year, we stayed engaged with the Fairport community by participating in morning messages and Raider Talk podcasts, joining countless Google Meets with our classmates and teachers, studying hard for online AP exams to earn college credit, and supporting each other by staying connected through social media. We filled our glasses as we worked to improve our senior year experience. No graduating class in recent history has experienced something quite like we have, and I hope that each of us will use these skills we have developed during these challenging times to to contribute to bettering our community wherever it is we may end up. At our home here in Fairport, this community that has raised many of us for 18 years will forever be a part of us as we cherish the memories of the Fairport school experience. To the class of 2020, congratulations, good luck, and remember, people who wonder if the glass is half empty or half full miss the point. The glass is always refillable. Thank you.
Thank you, Emily. It is now my pleasure to introduce the class president. Jane Kellerman has done an exceptional job bringing this class together. And Jane is off to the University of Vermont to study environmental studies. Please join me in welcoming our class president, Jane.
Class of 2020, congratulations. After 13 years at Fairport, it's finally come to a close. First off, I want to thank each and every one of you for allowing me to be the class president for the past 2 years. It has truly been the biggest honor. Ever since May of last year, ideas for this speech have been racing through my mind. I've given this speech in many variations, countless times in front of the mirror. I thought about the message I want to leave you all with. In my head, it was my speech and my words. Then I thought more about it. I'm just saying these words, but I think in a way you have all written this speech. I'm just the one to put it together and share it. I might be a bit biased, but this class is one of the most special throughout Fairport's history. We are graduating in a time that will be remembered forever. As a class, we have been able to come together and get through hard times as well as enjoy the great times. From every red zone to homecoming, we are lucky to be in a school where they have events that are just special to our district, like Brotherhood Sisterhood Week and Unplugged, that help separate our school from the rest. We've made amazing memories together over our course here at FHS. Each of us got the chance to make our mark here in Fairport, and I think for most of us, we can say we successfully did just that. High school is a time to find our passions and our interests and discover what makes us all unique. Whether it's sports, many of which winning big titles like sectional champions, as well as the unified sports teams, or the drama club who outdid the previous production every time. Maybe you were on the robotics team, designing robots I couldn't even fathom trying to make, or the band program with Mr. Tiberio, and the arts program where people, especially ones in our grade, excelled at. Fairport is extremely special in the way that there are countless clubs and classes that we can be a part of and find our place. Each of us had a different experience overall, thanks to Fairport for allowing us to have the chance to find ourselves. I think we all have to take a moment to thank and acknowledge the backbone of this school, the staff. Everything that happens within the walls of FHS can be credited to the staff. Without every teacher and mentor, I don't think any of us would be here today. From the time that we were 5 or 6 years old to now, we've been constantly pushed to be the best versions of ourselves we can be. We have to thank the ones that believed in us, that pushed us to be the best versions of ourselves that we could be. So thank you. Thank you for choosing this profession and making outstanding impacts on our lives. Next, I want to offer a bit of advice. I use this quote in my yearbook letter by Cory Booker, and I think it was extremely important to me to share today as well. You're going to go out for the big challenges, the big fights. I see you, and I love you. You're going to have tough days. You're going to fall. Going to fail, but I see you and I love you. May your vision and your love not just change the world, but make a world of change for everyone that you can. This is one of my favorite quotes, and I think it helps me convey my final message to you as a class. Life isn't always what you want it to be. It isn't a storybook where you can rewrite certain sections or plan out the way it goes. That's just not how life works. Each day there will be challenges, and some days they might be bigger than normal. Each challenge shouldn't be a setback. It should be part of your driving force. Life is never easy, but every morning that we wake up and complete another day is a victory and a sign that we are meant to be here. It's safe to say, as a class, we experienced a huge challenge. Our graduation is happening during a time of hardship and will be a critical moment in history. This wasn't easy, but we did it, and we did it together. Another thing I want to touch on is making an impact. Not all of us are going to cure cancer or be the first person on Mars. You don't have to be a billionaire or a superstar to make a difference. If you are passionate, use your voice. A small impact is still an impact. Like Mr. Booker says, your love and vision can make a world of change for people. I'm so proud of you all. Whether you're going to college, the workforce, the military, or just trying to figure it out, I wish you all the very best of luck. I cannot believe that we will all be Fairport High School alumni by the end of this ceremony. I can't wait to see the amazing things you'll all accomplish. I love you all very much, and congratulations.
Great job. Thank you so much, Shane.
The Fairport High School Student Hall of Fame exists annually to recognize students who have achieved distinction in their careers at FHS in academics, extracurricular activities, citizenship, service, leadership, and spirit. It is our pleasure to announce the following members of the Class of 2020 that were recently elected to the Student Hall of Fame. Congratulations to Renee Dozier, Josie Keenan, David Munichika, Emily Pollack, Morgan Schwab, and Eden Yarbrough on this well-deserved and prestigious honor. We look forward to celebrating with them later this summer. Congratulations to all the members of the new Student Hall of Fame, Class of 2020. Thank you.
Mr. David Munichika is the valedictorian of Class of 2020. David is on his way to Georgia Tech this fall to major in computer science. Please join me in welcoming David.
Good evening, Class of 2020. You know, I was planning to start off with a live performance of our class anthem, I Saw Thing, but Mr. Clark said he didn't know the words, so I feel like he'd just be missing audience participation now. And yes, for all of you asking, I did write my college essay on managing a high school rap label. Rest in peace, Fairport's finals. So instead, I'll begin with a quote from my biggest role model, Kanye West. We can't dwell on the past. All we got is today. So I'm gonna live like it's no tomorrow. No goodbyes. I apologize if you're a T-Swift fan, but I think Kanye's right. It's easy to dwell on the past, to think about what we miss. But those things should never overshadow all the experiences we did have. The leadership and Boston trips, chirping the other team from the red zone, sinking a shot of hat ball as the entire class is watching. I know Mr. Page can't relate to that last one. Our class had a string of sports successes. We had our soccer, cross country, lacrosse, cheerleading, and tennis teams win sectionals, making state runs. And last year, we were named New York's best high school for athletics. Each year, we've had incredible concerts, including Unplugged in prison, amazing musicals and plays, and, quite possibly, our biggest accomplishment of all, we designed the greatest flash shirt in history. We've had some amazing accomplishments, and still today, I think graduation's bigger than all that. It's bigger than the past. It's bigger than sticking to the tradition of what's been done before. Lining up in the back of Blue Cross, hearing your name, walking across the stage. And if there's ever a class to break tradition, to do it hasn't been done before, it was us. Our class is special. Of course, since the dawn of time when they handed out stone diplomas, every graduation speaker has said their class is special. But I think the class of 2020 has them beat. You might have heard of the term black swan being used lately. It was coined by author Nassim Taleb to describe entirely unpredictable, extremely improbable events, like finding an actual black swan. I mean, imagine a day when every senior walks leisurely out to the parking lot after school. That's a black swan. We are the black swan class. Our school milestones have been marked by three black swan events. We were born in the wake of 9/11. We started school together in the middle of the Great Recession, and we're graduating during a global pandemic. Yet we're still here. We're still moving forward. See, we can't control everything that happens to us, but we can always control how we respond. This class is special because we did that. We're resilient. We stuck together while being physically far apart. Of course, there are times when we were disappointed. I mean, you know, things must be bad when kids actually want to go back to school. But I think we've all learned valuable life lessons, which is why we're going to come out of this quarantine stronger than before. We learned not to take normal for granted. Just going to school, leaving your house, not being interrupted in the middle of the day by a parade of 50 cars all honking their horns for your neighbor's 13th birthday party. We learned to value the everyday life. It's easy to feel like we had something taken from us when second semester got canceled. But it's important to remember all we've been given, and everyone that's invested in us during our time here at Fairfield. I know personally, I would not be in the position I am today if it weren't for a countless number of people who helped me along my journey. My family, who showed unconditional support every day. My teachers, for giving me guidance inside and outside the classroom. My coaches, who taught me lessons that transcend athletics. Coach Fitch always said, life is too short to not spend it around special people. Which brings me back to all of you, class of 2020. I'm truly grateful to have spent the past 12 years of my life surrounded by a group of such amazing and special human beings. So, as our time in high school is coming to a close, I hope you'll join me in making your own life a black swan. Make it extraordinary. Don't settle for normal, because your life is a once-in-a-lifetime event. As 21st century philosopher and street poet Kendrick Lamar once said, I was a black sheep, but now I'm just a goat. Don't get me wrong, it's not going to be easy, because these are uncomfortable times. Swans might appear calm on the surface, but they're paddling furiously under the water. But don't be afraid to be uncomfortable. Don't be afraid to fail. Don't be afraid to lean on each other. If there's anything this pandemic has taught us, it's that people are there for you, even when you're apart. And don't wait. The world needs extraordinary people now. You might feel the future is too uncertain, but the future has always been hard to predict. Nobody knew March 13th would be our last day walking the halls of FHS. I remember back in freshman year, all my teachers said it'd be over before I know it. This wasn't what I thought they meant, but they're right. And the same holds true for life. So don't wait. As we graduate from high school, closing one door, reaching for the next, let's confront the uncertainty in the world as an opportunity to make a difference, to be leaders. Because there is no leadership without uncertainty. And the best leaders emerge in the most uncertain times. Class of 2020, embrace this as an opportunity to make your life extraordinary, to make your own life a black swan. Thank you and congratulations.
Great job, David. Thank you so much. It is now my pleasure to introduce the DA Jazz Band under the direction of Mr. Bill Tiberio to offer a musical tribute to the class of 2020. Our next speaker will be introduced by the vice president of the class, Ms. Morgan Schwab, who's headed off to the University of Virginia to study political science. Morgan?
Hello, everyone. My name is Morgan Schwab, and I'm very excited to be able to introduce our teacher graduation speaker, Mr. Alessandra. There's no greater honor than being selected as the voice of the class of 2020, and it is my privilege to be able to welcome him to the stage today. Now being in his fifth year as a full-time teacher at Fairport, he has been able to make connections with students that he will cherish forever. Mr. A met our class being a long-term sub at JP Middle School, and then was able to greet us at the high school our sophomore year. He feels that the special connections he made with our class were very easily rekindled at the high school. He feels lucky to have been able to watch our class grow and emerge, and he has recognized our class as special because no matter how much time apart there was from us, their relationships never faded. Some teachers might not make it their first priority to build relationships with their students. However, this is most important to him. When some students very close to him have been asked to describe Mr. Ed, they chose the words compassionate, trustworthy, thoughtful, personable, generous, considerate, and lighthearted. Personally, I can't think of a better way to be seen as a person by others. On top of that, he is also very successful. Among all of his accomplishments here at Fairport, he believes that being selected as our teacher speaker is the greatest honor yet. Knowing that speaking in front of our class is his most proud moment just shows how much he cares for the class of 2020, and that is a good feeling. Although I never was lucky enough to be able to sit in one of Mr. A's classes, I did have the opportunity to go to his room during study hall with our president, Jane Kellman, every other day in the second semester. From the first day I walked into his room, I knew he was such a good person and a teacher. I also was able to experience how funny he is, and everybody sitting in front of me that has had him as a teacher would agree. He is the kind of person to listen to whatever you have to say, whether it is a serious conversation or one that involves showing him multiple TikToks. Either way, he wanted to hear what we had to say. Even though my time was cut short getting to know him, I know that he radiates positive energy and represents Fairport spirit in the best way. He's very deserving of this honor, and he has invested time getting to know the class of 2020. It is obvious that the connections and relationships he has created with our class are important to him. Fairport is a special place full of amazing teachers, and Mr. A consistently adds to this reputation every year. We voted for him to represent our class because his ability to create meaningful and lasting relationships makes him a unique individual that has influenced many. He has a bright future here in Fairport as a young teacher, and he will have the opportunity to impact many students in years to come. The class of 2020 will never be forgotten, and nobody could have imagined it would end this way. Mr. Alessandro will forever be remembered as the one to address our class during such a time in history. So please join me in welcoming him to the stage.
Thank you, Morgan, for the wonderful introduction and your incredibly kind words. Good evening, all, and welcome to the commencement for the Fairport Class of 2020. To my family, and to all the families, friends, and staff here tonight, thank you all for being with us. Not just for your presence, but for the constant support, unwavering faith, and the unconditional love you give us that drives us all to be the best version of ourselves. I've never given a speech of this magnitude before, and I'm not an experienced public speaker. While preparing for this, I read that public speaking is one of the greatest fears among people. However, despite being completely inexperienced for this type of speech, that wasn't my biggest fear. Coming from an extremely short Italian family, I was more concerned that I wouldn't be able to see over the podium. So I guess I conquered my fear tonight. I'm going to speak tonight for about 13 minutes. You deserve to know this because I also read in my preparation that there is no joy a speaker can give an audience that compares to the joy they feel when the speech is over. So just for your reference, you can all look forward to experiencing that joy in about 13 minutes from now. When I was selected to be the commencement speaker months ago, I knew I had to take this task seriously. So I decided to prepare my speech with the same intense dedication I see my students put into doing their schoolwork. So late last night, I began working. I asked my friends to send me notes on Snapchat. I did a quick TikTok dance. I know, that was cringy, right? And just like you, I used only the finest sources the internet has to offer. I think it was Wikipedia that said it best when they wrote, "Graduation is the award of a diploma or academic degree, or the ceremony that is sometimes associated with it in which students become graduates. The date of graduation is often called," get this, "Graduation Day." Nailed it. Thanks, Wikipedia. But seriously, graduates, it is hard to believe that your time at Fairport is coming to its end. This wasn't the ending you envisioned or the ending you deserved, but I am so humbled and honored to speak to all of you tonight. I first met members of this class in the seventh grade when I was a long-term sub at JP. I was hired the following year as a special education teacher at the high school. I was asked to co-teach global history with the amazing Mrs. Allie Moore for the 2017-18 school year. And that's when so many familiar faces and new personalities walked into my classroom. Over the years, I have watched you learn. I have embraced your laughter. I have seen your kindness. I have witnessed your hard work. I have been in awe of your ability to build connections and relationships with others. I have been inspired by your passion. Watching you all grow into young adults has been one of the highlights of my young career. I have shared so many memories with this class, but when I look back at the last 3 years with you all, I don't remember much about teaching some of you global history. I just remember how fun this class was. I remember laughing uncontrollably in fourth period global with Morgan Wells and Jack Lindstrom to the point that I had to leave Mrs. Moore and step out of the room to compose myself. I remember playing Bachelor and Bachelorette Tinder in study hall with Claire, Ethan, and Eden. I remember listening to Aaliyah's Mike is Judgy Spotify playlist. FYI, I'm Mike. I remember giving my first ever Proud to be a Raider DASA card to Maddie T. I remember rapping to California Love on Bus 5 to Boston. I remember tearing up the dance floor with Jack Crane on Senior Trip. I remember cheering with the Red Zone at countless sports events. I remember all the lunchtime and lounge visits from Jane and TGC. I remember the endless conversations about life with Molly Walsh and so many others whom I never even had in my classes. Those are the moments I hold on to. This class just has an energy about it that reverberates down the halls. Now, some commencement speakers will come out and tell you to reach for the stars or to chase your dreams, but you've heard all that before. I want to talk to you about life. So if I can leave you with some advice for your journey ahead, be kind, be humble, and don't be afraid to take risks. Babe Ruth once said, "Don't let the fear of striking out keep you from playing the game." This holds so true in life. You can never know the true scope of your influence or abilities unless you are willing to step outside of your comfort zone. The only thing holding you back is yourself. So if you get a chance, don't be afraid to take it. And if it changes your life for the better, let it. Take care of yourself. Everyone is going to have their struggles in life. Don't allow your obstacles to become permanent barriers. The struggles are just part of your story. Your story isn't over yet. Remember that your mental well-being is vital. Don't put anything else before your own health. And when you're having a bad day, a long week, or a rough year, do me a favor. Take a deep breath and put your hand right here. Do you feel that beating in your chest? That is purpose. Your purpose. Everyone at some point or another is going to question their purpose in life, But I'm here to tell you, you've already fulfilled your purpose. When you paid for that person's coffee in line behind you, when you took those extra few seconds to hold the door for someone, when you smiled at a stranger, when you comforted a friend who was hurting, when you spent an hour of your free time volunteering or donating blood. You see, the world's problem is that people too often relate their success and their purpose to tangible or goal-based achievements. But the fact is, the universe doesn't care about your achievements, just your heart. Strive for growth. Strive for better. The world needs your light. Life will only give back to you what you are willing to put into it. So when you choose to live your life by acting out of kindness, compassion, empathy, and love, you have already fulfilled your greater purpose. That is your meaning. And I need you to remember that always, because there are going to be things that happen in your life that will seriously test your will. You know this well because you've experienced it this year. In this world, you must learn resilience and perseverance. Find ways to keep fighting, because you will have your heart broken. You will embarrass yourselves. You will be rejected. You will fail. It's okay. It's part of life. I had almost 20 schools tell me no before Fairport told me yes. And look where I stand now. Sometimes it only takes one yes in a sea of no's to change your life. So practice patience and wait for your opportunity. But in the times when you do fall, fall forward, get back up, and turn your misfortune into learning experiences. Turn your failures into a catalyst for change and growth. You all are stronger than you know. One of the most iconic movie characters of all time, Rocky Balboa, once said, "Nobody is going to hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. You are not defined by your struggles, but by how you respond in the face of adversity. I once had a teacher tell me I wasn't college material. I also once had someone tell me don't get your hopes up when I told them what I wanted to do with my life. But that didn't stop me from chasing my passions. In fact, it became my inspiration, because one thing I strive to do as an educator is make sure no student ever feels as undervalued as I did in those moments. Life is going to bring you to the highest of highs and the lowest of lows, but you need to remember you are never alone. You are surrounded with support, love, and people who want the best for you, whether you can see it or not. So when the going gets tough, don't ever be ashamed or embarrassed to reach out for a helping hand. Everyone needs support. Don't be afraid to seek it out. And don't ever let anyone diminish your value or make you question your self-worth. As Eleanor Roosevelt once said, "No one can make you feel inferior without your consent." Don't let others define who you are. Be who you are. Believe in what you feel. Embrace each other's differences and love who you want. And trust me, if along the way someone is willing to up and walk out of your life, let them go. Those who truly love you will come into your life instead. They will celebrate your highs and endure the harshest conditions by your side without hesitation. I also ask, while you're on your journey, that you be present. Some of you will say that high school dragged on, but most of you will admit it flew by faster than you expected. So will life. Try your hardest to live life in the moment. The time you spend doing things you truly love is never wasted time. Time is the one thing you can never get back, but something you can always give. Time only exists now, in the present. So time spent dwelling on the past or worrying about the future is done at your own risk. Nothing you do can change the past. Don't look behind you. You aren't going that way. You are moving forward. And the fact is, you have no way of completely knowing where you're headed. Your path at 18 may not necessarily be your path at 28 or 38, because dreams have no expiration date. Once you realize that you cannot control what happens in your life, that the plans you make for yourself are not set in stone, it will relieve so much anxiety you have. So, be present in your academics, be present in your work, and when that's over, be present with your family and friends. Being present is the only way to see people for who they truly are and to make meaningful, lasting connections with others. Remember, all you get in this life is time and choices. Be wise with both. Lastly, be thankful and grateful for what you have. And this is the part of my speech I'm so sorry I can't say to you all in person. You all have been so blessed to grow up and receive an education in a community that surrounds you with so much support and love. I am so thankful for all of you. Even though I'm only 31, I've asked myself before, what is my meaning? What gives my life value? And I've realized a big part of that answer is, you all do. Robin Williams once said something that holds so true to me. He said, I don't know how much value I have in this universe, but I do know I made a few people happier than they would have been without me. And as long as I know that, I'm as rich as I ever need to be. You have shown me that I am indeed a rich man. This class has meant more to me than my words can ever express. There are so many of you that have made such an amazing and lasting impact on my life and have made being a teacher such a rewarding experience. You all have taught me so much more than I could have ever taught you. You all made me a better educator and a better person. I want you to know that I am nothing without you. I am so grateful for all the memories we've shared, and they'll stay with me forever. You have been such a bright spot in my life over the past 3 years, and while I will miss you all dearly, I cannot wait to see all of the amazing things life will bring you. And I know the class of 2020 will always be at the forefront of my mind when I look back on my career in Fairport. I have one final quote from author A.A. Milne to express my feelings toward this class. How lucky I am to have something that makes saying goodbye so hard. I know goodbyes are never easy. The more you care about something, the harder it is to let go. But I promise you, if you choose to make the moments count, you will always have something to hold on to. You all are about to embark on your own journeys, but just remember, no matter where life takes you, you can always come home. Once a Raider, always a Raider. Class of 2020, you make me so proud to be a teacher at Fairport High School, and I am so proud of each and every one of you. Work hard, be kind, and amazing things will happen. I wish you all nothing but health and happiness in everything life brings you. Now, you've waited a long time for this. So, let's get you graduated, and let's finally get this party started. Congratulations, Fairport Class of 2020. Thank you.
Thank you so much for that heartfelt message, Mr. Alessandro. It's now time for our presentation of the class gift. And our next guests have a special presentation to make on behalf of the class of 2020. Please welcome our secretary, Josiah Keenan, who's headed to Penn State University to study film and science, and our treasurer, Emily Pollack, to the stage to present the class gift.
Hello to my fellow class of 2020 and the Fairport community. My name is Josie Ann Keenan, and I'm the class of 2020 secretary.
And I'm Emily Pollack, and I'm the class of 2020 treasurer.
It has been an honor working with the other class officers this year, and as a group, we have taken on many tasks. Among these responsibilities, we had the chance to decide on a class gift. This tradition of the graduating class giving a class gift is a great way to give back to the community and Fairport High School. So, after many votes and ideas being tossed around on how the class of 2020 should give back, we have decided on a very special class gift. My fellow class officers and I have chosen to give back to four specific funds and causes. The first of these is the Joey Fund. This fund is designed to help families in the Fairport District that are facing unique financial hardships. From poverty to medical situations, the Joey Fund will help these families pay for various needs, as well as specific Fairport events. From trips to instruments, to even gift cards to Wegmans, this fund is aimed to help those in financial troubles while still keeping them involved in the Fairport community and Fairport High School activities. Next to the Joy Fund, the second fund we will be donating to is the TOPS Fund. This fund is for student opportunity and equity, meaning that students who cannot afford specific musical, athletic, or academic costs will be helped by the TOPS Fund. These costs can range from summer camps to field trips to booster club costs and more. Personally, being involved in the Red Zone, I have seen how much the TOPS Fund has helped out athletes and sports teams in various ways, and I'm thrilled to be a part of this donation, along with the rest of the class of 2020 officers. Now, I know this year has definitely been a roller coaster for all of us, and especially students, and even the rest of the world. But more specifically, the class of 2020 did not get the ending we deserved. So, the class officers and I had a conversation on how we can make the class gift unique to only the class of 2020. And we thought, why not donate to a cause that has affected this year on a worldwide scale. So we did some research and found our last piece to our gift. The main cause of the change to our senior year was due to COVID-19. This global pandemic resulted in the world being on lockdown and resulted in schools going on a long coronation, if you will. Now, although our senior year was cursed by this pandemic, this was not what mattered most during this time. Nurses, doctors, hospitals, nursing homes, and so many more were working nonstop in order to take care of those who were affected by COVID-19. They were working around the clock, so these patients remained safe and healthy during these scary times. Some of these first responders went days, even weeks, without seeing their families because they were risking their health in order to save others. And as we look back on what has happened this year, we should recognize these individuals and give back for all the hard work they are doing, and also give back to those affected by the coronavirus. So, we have decided to donate towards this cause in Rochester to help those affected within our community and support the individuals who have risked their lives to help. Recently, a man named George Floyd was murdered due to police brutality. Throughout history, the African American community has dealt with too many forms of hate that needs to come to an end. I was always taught to love and accept people, no matter what, and it pains me to see that African Americans are not receiving the love that they deserve. Sorry, this is falling. Okay. They deserve to be treated equal regardless of the color of their skin. And in support of the Black Lives Matter movement, the class of 2020 would like to donate towards this cause. Although this movement has touched lives on a global scale, Rochester was a main contribution to this movement and is also our home. So, we would like to donate towards the Black Lives Matter movement in Rochester to help rebuild the community and take a stand towards the unequal rights that the Black culture receives. In today's world, we need young, smart, and caring youth leaders that take a positive stand supporting equality and equity. And on behalf of your class of 2020 officers, we are proud to be a part of this change. Thank you.
ladies, and we thank the entire class of 2020 for your generous donations. And now the moment you've all been waiting for as we begin the presentation of diplomas.
Thank you.
And now for the conferring of the diplomas. Mr. Provenzano, would you please now do us the honor of conferring the diplomas?
Graduates, by the powers vested in me, by the New York State Board of Regents, and by the New York State Department of Education, I pronounce you official graduates of Fairport High School, class of 2020.
Let's hear it again for the class of 2020. Congratulations on a great year. We wish you all the very best. Take care, Fairport.